Form 101 must demonstrate how the proposed research program has the potential to make an original and innovative contribution. Reviewers are looking for a strong, well-conceived, and formulated proposal that addresses a significant research issue. They expect to see a feasible approach and awareness of other research pertinent to the issue. It's important to make a convincing argument about the impacts and significance of the anticipated contributions, and to demonstrate how these will advance your long-term research goals.
I think the applicant needs to start off by explaining what their research program is and outlining the long-term objectives, and then go from that to what's going to be done over the next 5 years of grant funding, so shorter-term objectives that cover the 5 years. And then for each of those objectives, explain the research that's going to be done, why it's significant, why it's going to advance the field, and then enough experimental detail or methodological detail that the experts reading it are convinced that the work is feasible and can be carried out by the applicant. And then finally to show how students or trainees at all levels are going to be involved in the work, what their role is going to be, why one project is suitable for perhaps for a PhD student, but another is only suitable for an undergraduate, that kind of thing.
It articulates a new idea, and it really gets us excited about some aspect of the science that this person is going to do. And what you want people to go is say, wow, I never thought of that way. This is really interesting. And I think people are really scared to kind of go that little extra way to put the higher risk elements in their proposals. But time and time again, sitting around the committee table, I see that is what people are looking for when they're looking for innovation.
Une des erreurs les plus fréquentes, c'est de mettre trop de projets dans une demande de 5 pages sans être capable de donner toute la méthodologie ou la faisabilité ou toutes les informations nécessaires aux membres du comité pour être capable d'évaluer que ce projet-là est un projet viable et valable. Alors ça, c'est une des plus importantes fautes qu'on retrouve, c'est de trouver trop de projets mal expliqués. C'est mieux d'avoir moins de projets, mais avoir des projets qui sont bien expliqués, dans lesquels on peut juger de la pertinence et de l'impact que ces projets-là vont avoir pour l'avancement des connaissances.
There has to be enough for the experts to convince them of the feasibility and the impact of the work. And often that involves referring to papers that you have published that show the techniques that can be used and setting the work in the context of the field you're working in. But at the same time, the non-expert can be overwhelmed by a wealth of experimental detail. And so it's important to have in general statements about what the work hopes to accomplish and how it's going to advance the field in language or in terms that are not specific to that particular field.
I would never advocate that anybody should inflate their budget. What I would argue is that you be perfectly honest in what you put forward. So if your research is research that costs a lot of money to do, state that very clearly. There are a number of things that we put in our budgets that are pretty standard across all universities. So graduate students, expenses, those types of things are all straightforward. But it's in certain techniques, it's in certain analytical things and various things where the costs really begin to separate themselves out. Or, for example, where you're doing your research. There are some very high cost places that people do research and those types of things. You need to put those in. Put them in and justify them, but do not inflate them, because these committees are very, very good at finding where there's excess in budgets.
In the grant application, there's an area for explaining overlap with other sources of funding. And that's a good spot to be very explicit about what your other sources of funding cover and how that is different from the NSERC grant. In the proposal itself, you need to focus on the work that is being proposed for the NSERC Discovery Grant, and the long-term objectives, the short-term objectives, and so on. But explaining the relationship with other research support can go into this other section where you can state, you can, for example, provide the abstract for that other grant, but also provide a summary statement as to how the research that you're proposing for your Discovery Grant is different from, distinct from, perhaps complemented by the CIHR-funded research, but definitely different from it.
Il faut avoir un budget qui est très cohérent avec la recherche qu'on propose. Aussi, c'est très important pour les chercheurs qui ont plusieurs subventions de différentes sources de bien démontrer comment ces subventions-là n'ont pas de chevauchement, soit budgétaire, soit conceptuel, soit dans la recherche. Et ça, les membres du comité portent beaucoup attention à ce qu'il n'y ait pas de double financement pour la recherche.